Today we're gonna learn more about how to do data link. Data link is all about linking Visual Basic and another program, e.g. database, that is MS Access. And how this will can link can help you to make sure that the information that you put here can be saved in your database for future reference. That means once you put for registration form, you can either print the record, on the other side, you can have some backup. That is the most crucial side of data link. What you need to do is that this tool that you can see is called data, is the one you need to come here. You click there and you come, once you click there and come here, you draw it, and that is this tool. Once you draw here, you can give the name here as DAT register, and then you type here the caption student list, depending with what you want to put in that form. That means that the most crucial to understand. And once you type that form and you have any other layout of this form, for example, you can see there's a certain computer college registration form. This registration form, it have a name of beneficiary, it have gender, date of birth, ID, stroke passport, country of origin, we have estate, certificate, you have courses, we have certificate, diploma, advance, and other courses. Contact information, you can see of the mobile phone, email, we have the next of kin, whereby you have parents' name, father and mother, and we have the date and land. Those are the most crucial information in our registration form. That means we have this information, now we need to have some backup. First, after doing all this in this form, just go to add-ins. At the add-ins, we have add-in manager, and you have the visual data manager. I need to come to visual data manager. Once you click visual data manager, then you can come to file, you click new, then you click MS Access, and you choose a version 7.0. Then once you click there, it will give you a room for saving your database, and you give it a name. But in my case, because I have a ready database, I can just come to open database, I come to access, and I click there. I choose this database, that is SACHEM Kenya database, I just click there, and I click open, because I have already existing one. As you can see, we have this one for the diploma student, we have the employee payslip, and then I need now to add the third one. It means I just come in the property, I right click there, and I click new table. I just go to the property, right click, then you click new table. You can see now we have another window here. You can come here, you put now the information for the table. You can just drag it there and you put the relevant information on the table. But for this one, you need to come here. I call it that is a SACHEM. That is, you put SACHEM college registration form. That's the name of a table. Then to add the field, just click there to add the field. Then you can just click there. You see some of the most crucial information, that is about the name of beneficiary, gender, and ID. Just come and click there. And now once you click there, you can come here, you choose that information and start putting it here. That means here we have a name or student name. That is one is a text, just click OK. We have the other one is gender. Then you can still see a text. We have DOB. By that one can be date stroke time. For this one, you can just choose date stroke time. Okay. And you have the other one is just click then confirm ID number, county of origin, estate. have ID, number, stroke, passport, number, then that can be a text because a combination of numbers and text in this case, or you can still choose a memo for this. You can choose memo, which is a combination of all those, then or else you can just come here, choose just text, which can be just a combination of all those. Then you click OK. Once you click that one, we have now another one called what we have the mobile number. You need to have a mobile number for this. We have the contact information, but before that one you can put county and nested. You have the county of origin. We have another one is nested. And after estate, now you can come to certificate. You have diploma. You have advanced. And you have others. We have mobile number. Yeah, but that can be for this one can be an integer or can be a single. For this case, I can just come and choose single for those numbers. Like okay, and then I can cut here. I put the email address. And you have next, you have fathers, which is now a text. You have mother, text. You have date and old. Yeah, there can be date of time for that one. Now click OK. Once you put that information there, which was the most crucial information there, now you can come here, you put either a primary key, whereby for example we have admission number, and the main number whereby can be a text in this case, then from there say okay. And now close. You can come here to add index here, and you put admin as the add index. Okay, and close. This is now admin. Then you click build the table. Once you click the build the table, you can see now you have three tables here. And you need to right click there. Come, I right click this one, I click open. Once you click open there, now you can see here, you can just come here, I put all this information there, and now I come, I click, if you type anything there, you can see that anything is coming, so it means you have to click add, and now you come and put now the name, Henley, Nyakombe, Nyasiko. We have now the gender is male. We have date of birth, which is now 12/19/88. We have ID number, which is now 253 1212. Once we put that one there, which is now there, we have the ID number there. You can see there, it's okay. Country of origin is Kakamega. And now you have the estate. The current living is Maradaima. To put that one, you can just scroll there. For this one is now that one, you can just put not applicable. And now you come to diploma. You come put all packages. That one you can just put not applicable. Not. Now you can scroll there and put the mobile number 0726 94 34, and you put the email address, which can be in Henry, and Yasiko at yahoo.com. Once you put all those information there, fathers is John Nyakombe, and mothers can put Emily Nyakombe. Then we have the date enrolled. It is 2nd February 2016. Once you feed that information there, those are the was one of the most relevant information. You have already put all of them there. You can click update. Most you can see now the admin cannot be present, so it means you have to correct all those errors there. It means you have to come here to look the admin here, whether they have a mistake or not. If they don't have most admin there, you can come here. You put now that number, for example, like that, and you click now update. You can see automatically I've updated in my system. I have one record there. I can just come here, I click add. And now I put another record here, whereby I can put now another name for this, or maybe at least a list of them, whereby you can now put all those information. And don't forget to put this admission number, because that's one of the primary key. See, that is the information there. You need just to come here, you put all the information there. And now once you put all this information there, you put those one, you can just put not applicable for that one. Now put not applicable there. for the phone number. So for the phone number, email address, we have the information there. Once we put there, we have the crucial information, just the one we are putting there. We have the information there. Put all the relevant information there. That is the data node. This is very crucial. Don't forget to put all the relevant information, because the moment you mess, you end up getting the wrong answer. In this case, it means admission number. You must put that kind of admission number there. Also put the admission number. You can see that. You can just drag a little bit there to see the admission number. It's very crucial. Don't forget. Now click update, and once you click update, you can see those are two records there. As you can see now, I have two records. I can choose to add the third one like that. Information there. So that all of the information should be required there. So don't forget to put it all the required information for that. All the information there. Example. Can just come and put all the relevant information there and put without no problem. And in that simpler way. Without no issue of contradiction there, just come and put all the information there. Can just drag it a little bit down and put the other information there. Just click there, now put all the relevant information required here. So that all the information is very crucial for that. So that you just put all the relevant information, which is required. permission required now. You can just put like that one without no issue of contradiction. And you can now put, and once you are through, now you can come here, you just click update. Once you click update, now we have at least, now the list of 1 is 2, 3. So you have that list, you have that one, and you have that one there. Those can be enough for me. Just close there. I come, I close here, I close all those. Once I close all those, now I go, I come back to where I am with this one. Now I can come here with this form of mine here, whereby now I have this form of mine and start working on this, starting with this database there. I need to click there, and then I come to database name. As you can see here, you have the database name, so click this database, which is now the data link. And now you come here at the database here, click there and choose the database. Your database, you need to come here, you look the folder where you saved your files. It means you have to go to the drive C, and I look my folder here, which is now searching Kenya Pro 2015, then click 2018, then you click now the database, search M Kenya database, and I click like that. As you can see here, now you can see the link for that database. Scroll down there until you see record source. You have this record source. This record source, just click there and now choose the name of your table. This is the name of a table, such as Mkoloji Registration Form. Just come here and click. As you can see here, you can just try to drag a little bit there. Now you can see the name of database here, the name of the table here. You just choose there. Once we choose now, just move up again. And now come look something else. So this now I can just come and click name of beneficiary there. As I choose name of beneficiary, and come to data source, I choose the name of this data DAT register, which is now this one. I'm linking with this now. I click data field, and I choose the student name. I come to this gender. I do the same without not becoming tired. Just choose DAT, then come here, you choose gender, and you work with all every side of it without no problem at all, and you can manage like that. Yeah. Case, as you can see, we have this one of them there by line. Now we have the admission number, but for this one we have not drawn for the admission number, and it's one of the most crucial because it's a primary key. So it means you have to create a room for that one, for that admission number, whereby either can be here on this down here, you create room for that one, or somewhere up there. Let me just create the text box for that one there. As I create the text box there, I can just come and remove that one, and now I put at the top here, I just come here, I put admission number, that is the TXT and the main number. Once you put like that one there, you can come here, you click the label, and now you put the admission number for this. So it means this is a primary key. You have to make sure that every time, don't forget to put the admission number here, because if you fail, automatically give you an error for that. It means you have to be very keen while you are putting the other information. This bear, you know some of them, but you have to put the admission number automatically. You need to put there, or else you can come, there is two more options there. You can just come here and choose. As for this one, you can just either put the text box there, or because we have those list of those admission number, for example, maybe you have them there, you can just come and delete, and now you put a cover box. While you put the cover box here, it will be a bit easier so that you can create a list of them there as those admission number. Just put that one, then you come here, you put the CBO admin number. Once you put the admin number there for the CBU admin number, now you will come here, you put the relevant information in that CBU. It means just come here in the form load there, just double click form load, and once you double click the form load there, you can come where you have added the courses there. Now for certificate, for diploma, I can come here down, now put with CBO admin number dot. So we just come, you press enter, dot text is equals in quotes, just put select admin admission, select the admins admission. Center for dot add item space, just put quotes and you put the admission number here. As for example, this admission number should be you have to for you have 4/SEMT/2014. You have the quotes, press enter, Now you put dot add item there, space, put quotes, and put those kind of digits there, stroke, SCMT, stroke 2014, enter, you have dot add item there, space, put those kind of digits there, and now put stroke SCMT, stroke 2015. Close the quotes and keep adding them there as many as you can. As for this one, and make sure that those numbers, they are a bit unique, not to be the same, so that you can be a bit easier and a bit realistic in this 2016 there. You can just come here, you write entire of them there. For example, those aren't there. You copy them. Once you right click, just come, you copy, then you keep here the bottom and right click, just paste. Once you paste there, you can now come, we do some changes here and there. For example, that number, just come, we put that number there. We just put that number, and then you can remove it for that number. Now to make it full that number. Those one you make a bit difference, and still here can be 2017, it can be 2017, it can be 2016, and this can be 2016. Just put like that. Once you are through with those one, you can just press enter and you put add width. Goes add width. Have to make sure you click add width like that. Once we are through with that one automatically, now you'll be in a position to reflect in this. So what you need to do, once you're through that section first, just click run, and now bring, see this one, you give you now the employee, and this was not my interest, just close that one, and then I go to project explorer property, sorry, then I come here, I choose FRM registration, I click OK. Then I click start. Now you can see the information, first information there, which is now well reflected there. The first information in my form now, they have all the information there. As you can see, we have the crucial information for all the ones that you require. So for example, it is for all packages there. For this one, you have all the packages there. And here you have HCAD and AutoCAD. This is not applicable. We have the phone number, we have the email address, we have all the relevant information in here. You can come here, select the that one as the admission number for that one. And once you put there, automatically you come here and put this. But in this case, because this information was there, only that it was not been linked here, it means you can just come here, you close there. And now you click here, you put the link for that. As by the way, you put in the other, still you can do the same. You just come here, look at the bottom here, you can see we have admin number link like that one. And once you click, now you can click there and you see automatically give you now the number for that admission number, but you have now the rest numbers whereby they are just appearing that. Now the next thing is how I can update this. Now this menu, as you can see, we have some button for new student, you have update record, you have print record. How can I update those to become active? Just click add, and now I can come here and I click this. As you can see, we have this one for DAT register. This is done there, DAT register. So that's one I'm gonna use there to link this. It means I double click this new student, then under this command button here, I can just come and write DAT register dot record set dot add new. That's all. Just close this one and you click update record. You write DAT register git register dot record set dot update. Then I close, and now you have this one for print record. You can just come here, you write, you put that sign, then you print print form press enter like that one, or else you put me dot print. You can either put that one or just put me dot print form. Either you can put even the coding for that one and just close those ones. And then the same coding here, you can just implement them here. Just come here and click new student. Once you click new student, that's for the menu. Just come and put DAT register dot record set dot add new. Go to the second menu here, I put update. I can just come here, I put DAT register dot record set dot update. Just come here, I put, for example, this one you can choose to open, for example, this receipt here. In case I have the receipt here, I can just come and choose employee. We have the receipt, you have the information. So for this one, if it's about FRM receipt dot, so for this one you need to come here and check what is all about that one, whether it exists or not. But in this case, it cannot be found there. Just come here. You see, we have the registration form. We have accreditations. We have diploma. We have the registration form for that one. It means that one is not yet combined. But you have this one for employee. You can just come here and now write FRM employee dot show. This one I can just remove there. I'm gonna put it later as for that. Then you have another for there. You can come here and choose, for example, calculations. I put FRM calculations dot. For example, if the mistake was being done previously, it means you have to recollect the same mistakes here so that they can work the same. So by mistake was written this to be you, so that's why you need to come here and put, and you can see now, coming information like that one without no hindrance. That is why you can see, you can just pull like that one as FRM diploma dot show. It is reflect now this one now. This for diploma. And this is how you link those file menu. You can go up to print record, and you can now have here you put that one, then you write print form. The other one here, just print exit, and you can just come and write unload me. This is how you work with all those menus. As you can see now, the coding for that one, which is now this coding for lower for exit, this coding for data new record, this for print, and now we have this one to update or save record. Those are the most crucial codings there, and that's you just put in the form load. As you can see, they are just close there. Now click run. It will give you the information for the first person. You can look for the rest here. You can see the rest here. You can just scroll here and see now the information. Now it's changing from one person to another. You can see that is information for Henry. Click there is for Jemima, and now you can see those are the three main people. So if I have now the list of a couple of now, for example, 10 students I need now to enroll for today or any other date, it means I just got to come here. Either I use this one here, just click new student, it will be blank everything here. Now I come, I put, for example, Musa Silma. We have the gender here. For this one, you can just come here, you put male. I have ID number. We have this, and let's put that one as ID number. And now you have the little birth as 23/3/1990. You have the estate and down home. You have county of origin. We have North Hall. Example county of origin, we have Busia. This one is now not applicable. We have this one for this one just for Photoshop, and this one, for example, it was about hardware. Working, and we have others not applicable. You can just come and put the mobile number 07. Now you can come and put the email, which is now silma at gmail.com. Mustafa, Mustafa Haji, and Sabrina, Debis. Now you have the admission number here, you can just come and put that one, and now you have date enrolled, which is now 23/6/2017. So put that one there. I can click update record there. Also click update record. Automatically you see to update and give you the list of next and the first product here. I just come scroll. Now you can see the record is already updated. Every information is updated in the system. It's as simple as that one. Just click. Can still use this file new, and you still see it work the same. Come and put Dennis Oriach. Support this is mayor. Have ID number. Have date of birth. Vestige. Nairobi. Have our diploma. And those are. that one you can just click there, file, then you click update record, automatically we update. That is how you work with that data link without no issue of prediction. We are done with how you can do some data link and make sure that is functioning without no problem. It will be automatically work well with that. I